And what makes a man kill? What makes him a criminal? Or a copper, for that matter? There never seems to be much difference between them. They're all thieves and liars. There's one bastard in particular. I've had a lot of time to think. To think about these questions. 3 life sentences for a crime I didn't commit. Oh, I've done plenty of villainy. And had lots of time to regret it. As well as think about paying back the man responsible for me being locked up. Along with the copper who helped him. But I'm getting ahead of myself. I suppose I should start at the beginning. Because that's what all those trick cyclists and psychologists wanted me to do when they tried to understand my terrible crime. It did no good saying it wasn't me. They just looked at the sentence the judge handed down. That was a laugh too. When you think of the favours I'd done that judge. Getting him young girls. Then helping him avoid a big scandal when one of them he was with got murdered. But there I go again. Getting ahead of my story. I never told those mindbenders what really set the course of my life. I suppose there had to be some sort of wickedness in me. But the trigger was my mother killing my granddad. I was 6 when it happened, in Sullivan's coal yard at the end of our street. Mum was strong and resolute and determined. She hit granddad with a hammer, the one they used in the coal yard to smash up lumps of coal. My dad, Joey, was there as well. He did nothing to stop her. Mum said what she did was to protect me. Later, I discovered the reason was something far more sinister that was going to blight my life forever, as it turned out. Back then, the war was still on. We'd survived the Blitz, and then came the doodlebugs, as the flying bombs were called. They were nothing compared to my mum's temper.
Gonna take a sentimental journey.
We present G F Newman's The Corrupted. Episode 1.
Gonna make a sentimental journey to renew old memories.
Mum, you home? It's me, Cath. Where is she? I hope she didn't go out and leave Brian on his own.
Ah, I suspect your dad's upstairs with him.
He better bloody well not be. Brian? Brian! Dad, what are you doing with him?
Nothing. Just having a natter, weren't we, Brian?
You start your nonsense with my son, that's all, you filthy sod.
Oi, watch that tongue of yourn.
I'll swing for you, you start that.
You shut your mouth, you daft cow.
Yeah, leave your dad there.
It's all right, Mum.
You tell her, Joey, shut her mouth. Or I'll shut it for her.
You bloody well try! Do you in? Get out!
You gonna lift up my girl!
Go on then! Hit me, Tiger Braden! Big boxing hero! You bloody well try it!
Cathy,
get out!
Please!
Get out!
Cathy! Stop it!
I told you to get
stop
out!
Stop it, Cath!
There was no stopping my mum at that point. She dragged her old man out of the house and along to Sullivan's yard. Outside, the street was dark and deserted. No gas lights were on because of German air raids. I pulled my jacket on over my pyjamas and ran after them, not even hearing the air raid warning. I hid behind a heap of coal. I didn't know whether I was more frightened about what Mum would do or in case she found me. As she swung at Grandad with that hammer, I couldn't stop shaking.
I put up with your nonsense all them years, Dad. I've had enough.
No. God. Joey. Help.
That's enough.
You won't never do that to him. Or no one else, you filthy, filthy bastard.
Let it be, Cat.
Oh, lovely cat. You topped him.
Good. I hate him. I hate you, Tiger Braden. Do you hear me? I hate what you've done to me.
Cat, on here. He's dead.
Are you sure?
I'd say he was all right.
Well, good riddance to bad rubbish. Ryan!
Right.
What are you doing here? You're shivering. Oh, Bri, you gone and wet yourself, lovey. Come on. We'd best get you out of them wet trousers before you get chapped legs.
Come on, Bri.
Mum picked me up in her arms and kissed me as we hurried away to our Anderson shelter. This was when my trouble started. Even though I felt safe, I was terrified of what she might do to me. Never once did she tell me off for being there, or not to say anything to my Nan or Uncle Jack. I knew if I did, Uncle Jack would murder her. He was a boxer like Grandad, only better, everyone said. I was scared in case I told him by accident. Later that night, Sullivan's yard took a direct hit from a German doodle bug. Grandad was found the next day with bits of coal embedded in what was left of his body. There, the matter ended. Or so it seemed.
Hello, young lovers, whoever you are. I hope your troubles are few.
Put them plates on the table, Brian. There's a love.
Oh, Mum.
Oh, we don't have to help. You should be off playing with the other kids.
It's all right, Mother. He likes helping me. You do, don't you, Bri?
Is Uncle Billy coming to the party now?
If the government can spare him, my darling. They might for this Festival of Britain, like. I don't know what our Jack will say about it.
He never liked him. Not from when you first took up with Billy.
No one could replace his dad for Jack.
Billy's a proper man.
It's a pity your Joey doesn't take after him and show some gumption.
Mum, he is!
Brian, go and find your cousin. Make sure he's getting his fair share of the grub.
Do I have to?
Now! I don't want to tell you again.
Whenever they talked about Uncle Billy or anything important, I was always sent off. Billy Hill wasn't my proper uncle. He used to live with us before he went to prison. He was a gangster. He'd pulled some big jobs. He specialised in ram raiding, driving a van into jewellers' shop windows and grabbing the loot. I wanted to be like him, have a life like him. But Dad says I was to get a proper education and lead a God-fearing life. I have come to fear God. In prison, I got to believing that what goes around comes around. At first, I kept having bad dreams about Mum getting punished for what she'd done to Grandad if I went to the police. Nan always says the Rozzers are the last people anyone should go to, not even if you was murdered.
There. Fish paste sandwiches. I smell like a bloody fish. They should keep you going. Oi, Brian, where's your Uncle Jack?
I don't know, Will. I ain't seen him.
He promised me a dance before dreary Mr. Attlee comes on the wireless telling us to tighten our belts some more.
I think he's helping my mum make some more sandwiches.
Don't make me laugh. Your Jack couldn't slice bread.
I'll tell him you was looking.
I'll tell him myself I see him. I expect he's getting drunk.
I'll go look for him then. Jack! Uncle Jack! Wim Booker's after you. She's looking for you.
Aye, aye, Jack. Your marching orders is wedding bells next, then the misery.
I should, Coco.
You lucky man. A bit of nookie ain't gonna stop you getting a light heavyweight title.
Nor's all this brown ale, Bobby.
Mum says she's no good. She ain't your girl, Uncle Jack, is she?
No, I've got no time for girls. I'm trying to go bananas.
Jack!
Eyes up, Jack.
There you are, Jack Braden. Where's that dance you promised me?
Oh, come off it, Win, with my two left feet.
It sounds like her on that Joanna's got two left hands. It don't stop her. Come on, after you can help me get some more sandwiches.
Try, Bobby.
You're quite a good dancer, really, Jack. Like Victor Sylvester, light on your toes.
I've got to be if I'm going to get a crack at a title fight.
I couldn't bear to watch you in the ring. I'd want to kill anyone who hurt you.
I'll do some hurting, Win, if I get a shot.
Let's go to our old Anderson shelter, Jack. Come on, be a sport.
What if your mum sees?
She's up to her armpits in sandwiches. She won't see. Come on. Come on. It'll be all right.
Oh.
What if someone comes out here?
Shh, in case my dad hears. He'll give me a right good wallop if he catches me.
Oh, he'd have to deal with me if he does.
Would he, Jack? Mm. Would you stop him bashing me?
Of course, it's not right, blokes hitting defenceless women.
He gave me a right royal leathering last night. I'll kill him one of these days, I swear.
You should have called me.
The welts on my bum. You could drive trams along them. I'll show you. Let me get my knickers down. Oh. Like tram lines they are. You can feel him if you want. You can. You like touching my bum, Jack. Go on, it's all right. Here, give me your hand. Oh, Jack, that's nice. Makes it feel better. You can touch me here as well, you want. Go on, I know you want to. Oh, Jack. Oh, Jack, that's nice. Oh, would you like to do me? Would you? You would, I can feel you want to.
Oh, Struth, win. Oh, oh. I can't get it in.
Yeah, let me do it. Oh, Jack. Quiet. Someone in here. My dad will go mad.
I'd better skedaddle.
Oh, no, Jack, no. Here, come on. Touch me here some more. Do it again, you want?
No, I'm in training when I can't. My trainer says I mustn't if I'm to get a crack at the title.
My dad says pigs might fly.
Well, I'm better than Freddie Mills any old day. Everyone says so. All I need is a chance.
Give me half a chance. I'd be away from this street like a shot. Everyone talks about me, saying I'm no good. You don't think I'm no good, do you, Jack?
Well, of course I don't win, but I got to think about boxing. My trainer says when you can't get out of the corner by the sixth round, that's when you wish you left the little bean in its pod. Look, I'll see you around when, all right?
Hello, young lovers, whoever you are. I hope your troubles are few. All my good wishes go with you tonight. I've been in love like you.
Have had to tighten their belts, go without the luxuries we expected after the tremendous suffering and hardships we endured. Now we have come through to a period where we can start a new phase in this country. The Festival of Britain is designed as a tonic for a nation, a new beginning for everyone after these past 6 years of further austerity and hardship.
Yeah, our austerity, our hardship.
For a loafer and a deserter, you don't look like you've gone short, Bobby Brown.
That's how I plan for it to stay, Mr. Watling.
Well, give me a glass of that ale before I decide to run you down to the police station.
Then we'd better get you off cut, Constable.
Jack! Uncle Jack! Nan says to make yourself scarce. That Ros and Mr. Watling is with the youngster from the orphanage.
It's a national holiday. We all get a day off, coppers as well.
He'd still nick you. They like that, Ros's.
I can outrun him any day, Bri. We'll see. Come on.
Bobby under close arrest, Mr. Watling.
I've been after you two buggers so long, I feel like I'm one of the family.
Jack, what's going on? Is Bobby nicked?
Not likely, Mrs. Braden.
Not today, Mrs. I'm off duty.
Oh. I couldn't run there to save my life, Mrs. Braden.
Who's this with you then? Your son?
A young protege from the orphanage. I thought I'd bring him along. Show him what real family life is like. He don't get too many treats from them nuns.
Well, I expect he's hungry. Of course he is. Let's get him a proper nosh up. Come on.
Nan fed that orphan good and proper. If she'd known then what he was going to turn into and what he was going to do to our family over the coming years, she might have drowned him instead. He was to become one of the most treacherous coppers ever. It was his perjured evidence that got me sent to prison for 30 years. I wasn't ever going to forget him. My only fear is that he might die before I'm released and I wouldn't be able to wreak my revenge. But I'm jumping ahead again. He had yet to join the police.
Out of the bloody place.
What's so funny, Jack Braden?
Life turning out so good.
Well, I suppose you was too busy with Win Booker to notice that copper's here.
What do you mean?
I was hoping to make some more sandwiches.
We'd get fat on those. PC Watling might be kind to orphans, but he'll still collar you.
Look, there's Mr. Hill!
Jack, it's Uncle Billy out of clink.
Oh, he can sling his hook, and he ain't your uncle, Brian.
Let's take a butcher's, see what he's got to say.
He's got nothing to say worth hearing, Bobby.
Jack hated Billy Hill, right from the moment Nan brought him home. Nan was a real good looker. Billy said she looked like Rita Hayworth. Jack didn't want to give Billy a house room, even though it was the house Billy bought for Nan that Jack lived in with her. The problem for Jack was, Billy always managed to grab the limelight. He brought a crate of real French champagne to the party and got things hotted up. Jack didn't like that either, but our neighbours did. Nor did Jack like the two tearaways Uncle Billy brought with him, the Richardson brothers from over the river. With Billy Hill there, no one wanted the party to end. It was Uncle Billy what ended it when he announced he was taking Nan up to the West End for a supper to celebrate his release from clink.
Look at him. You must think he's Gary Cooper.
You gotta admit, he is a hunk.
I've seen better looking faces on cheeses in the co-op, Kev.
Give it a rest, Jack, if only for Mum's sake.
The rat had left there before he went to prison, shacked up with a woman half his age.
He's everything a man should be. I'm gonna say hello, even if you're not. Billy!
Cathy, Oldman. A sight to gladden the heart. Look at you, darling. More beautiful than ever. Come here. You still know how to kiss, darling. Despite being married to Joey. Charlie, give me that package I bought for Kath. In the back of the jam jar, son.
What is it?
You'll like this. Well, if you don't, I can't take it back. The shop was closed when I got it.
Oh, Billy, it's gorgeous. You shouldn't have. My Joey will think we're carrying on.
Chance would be a nice thing, darling.
It's not right, giving another man's wife a dress like that. Even if he is kind of her stepfather.
What do you mean, Dad?
The rat's up to no good.
Brian, go and find your grandmother. Tell her Mr. Hill is here.
Oh, Dad.
Go on. I should rescue your mum.
He's an evil devil. Just watch him.
What about you, Jack?
Me? All I want is a crack at that light heavyweight title. I'm ready.
Well, Mr. Hill's your main. He's got the contacts.
I'd sooner have a hot poker shoved in my eyes.
Don't be daft, Jack. That killer left hook of yawn could get you to the top. Everyone says so.
I'll do it without the help of Billy Bloody Hill.
He's headed this way.
I'm going to get Kath.
Hello, tough guy. You look like you've been getting 3 squares a day.
Who's complaining?
Not like the rest of the country under Labour. You still handy with them German bands?
Had a couple of good fights.
Oh, knockouts, Mr. Hill.
Well, you sound like a handy person to have around, Jack. You could give me a bit of help, son.
Someone needs sorting out today, Mr. Hill.
Yeah, a couple of pantomime clans of Kray twins. They're making demands to a bookmaker pal of mine around the East End. He's not in the business to make them fat. He'd sooner pay the tax man.
Well, Jack can sort them Krays out, but he's got to have a chance in the ring, like a title fight.
What are you, his manager, son? If the army still wants you to fight in Korea, it'll be tough getting you fixed up.
That's why I went on the run in the first place, to box. I'm good.
He'd make mincemeat of Freddie Mills, Governor.
Not with the army after him. Unless I pulled a few strings and put you in contention. I'll get you a shot, Jack. Don't worry.
It's all the same to you. No thanks.
Mr. Thinnest Mug! Like he's got options, Mr. Hill.
Your pal's right, Jack. Take whatever help you can get and pay it back in kind.
I'm good enough to get to the top without your help.
Then you're better off down at Billingsgate boxing kippers. That's all you're good for. I could put that old Nancy boy Freddie Mills on his back after I'd done the craze. Charlie, get some more of them bottles over.
You ninny! He could put us on Easy Street, Jack!
I'd sooner bump on at the dock gate than be beholden to that louse.
Do anything for a crack at a title fight, Jack.
Anything but Billy Hill's help. Not after how he treated you carrying on like he did, Mum.
Any feelings I had that way for Billy have long passed, son.
I wish you hadn't offered to have him living back here with us.
Not only till he gets on his feet. I couldn't say no.
It's your house. He gave it to you for security. He was in and out of prison like a fiddler's elbow.
I don't want you moving out because of it, Jack. It's bad enough losing our Alice to the Holy Rollers or whatever they are, wanting to go off to Manchester.
What never happened, Mum.
It's you what I worry about, Jack. Learn to use Billy Hill and anyone else. You take what you want in life. That's what your dad never understood, and look where it got him.
Tiger Braden could have been light heavyweight champion.
Yeah, well, maybe, or could have been, ain't it, is it?
Just had a bit of bad luck.
Yeah, I'd say, well, the last German doodlebug landing right on top of him. You make your own luck, Jack. Billy's taking us all on a charabang to Kempton Park to celebrate the royal wedding. You remember what I told you. Learn to use him and anyone else.
Jack was reluctant to go racing with Billy Hill. He went to please his mum. My dad said me and my sister were supposed to go to school, but Billy said it would be an education. Nan told me not to tell the school. This was an education and a half, and more exciting. Racetracks and gangsters always means trouble, and it certainly wasn't long finding us down at Kempton.
I don't know what you and me are doing here, Jack. My boss wouldn't be too pleased. I told him I was at the hospital with my chest.
Makes you sick the way Billy lords it over everyone.
You could have said no and put him on his back.
I don't want to cause any trouble, Joey, for Mum's sake.
There's plenty heading our way. Jack Spot and his gang heading for that bookmaker's pitch. Quick, sharp. Warn Billy.
No. Let's see what happens.
Oh, I'm not sure.
Come on, ladies, make up your mind. Frank's trying to get his living.
Picking winners needs some thought, Billy. Anyway, time is a lady's prerogative.
As long as the race isn't over. Give me a rope on number six, Frank. Brown Derby to win.
£4 on number six, Sid.
Right, Frank.
Hello, Frank. You got my winnings, dear.
Your horse must still be running, Mr. Spot.
I'd check with your clerk if I was you.
The fact is, me old China, you ain't him.
Oh, it's you, Billy. I should have recognised the prison pallor. They let you out, then? Or did you climb over the wall?
Either way, I'm here now. Spotty.
Don't call me that, dear. I don't like it. Let's be having those winnings. I'll make it a flin.
Sling your hook, Spotty. The man ain't got nothing for you.
You ain't muscling in. I run this track now.
You're a ponce. You always was.
Billy, look out, he's got a razor!
I'll take that shiv, Spotty. Thank you, I had a shave this morning. You look like you could do with one. Here it is for you. Now sling you up. Before I give you a matching stripe on the other side of your boat.
Well done, Jack. Here. Here's a flint for your trouble. That left hook's worth its weight in gold to someone, Billy.
Too right, Frank. You can hear a lot about it if I have anything to say.
Hey, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new recipe?
Did you see it? Did you see how Billy done that mugging? Spotty didn't draw breath.
Oh, Jack was the real hero.
He give them mugs the old one too, all right?
Won't the Rosses come after you?
Why would they do that, Brian? The police are my friend.
Don't talk daft, Billy. He might believe you.
Yeah, he's not that daft, are you, Brian? I owe Jack a big one. But for your prompt action, son, it'd have been me and Queen Mary's having his boat race stitched up. I tell you what, I'll blow in old man Solomon's ear. He's a top boxing promoter, Gracie. We'll fix Jack up with a match against the next contender.
Oh, Jack, how about that? That's wonderful. What a chance.
What about it, Jack?
You'll make me part of your gang, Billy.
Laying in a spotty like you done today, son, makes you a marked man anyway.
I just don't want to be in anyone's gang.
What a mug. I've got people queuing up to throw in with me. Bobby here brings me schemes every day.
I've got another one up my sleeve.
Yeah, we'll keep it dark, son, and I'll buy you a lamp. What'd you say, Brian?
I'll join your gang. Any old day.
I want you to get a proper education. Make something of yourself.
Oh, Dad.
Joey's right, Brian. You don't want to end up a pearl diver. Education's what it'll be about in the future. Look at your dad. Going to night school and making his fortune clerking in Covent Garden.
What's a pearl diver, Nan? Is it bad?
You'd think so if you had to be one, me old China.
It's the poor sod who washes dishes in a hotel, my darling.
What's wrong with that?
You try it for sixpence halfpenny an hour. See what you feel there.
Like I'd feel if I went thieving with you.
No, son, no. It's redistributing. Making sure the little bloke gets a share. You'll come round, Jack, when the going gets tough. If not, we'll give Brian a go. No matter what his dad says.
I didn't want a proper education. Not the kind you got at school. Of course, at that age, I didn't appreciate the value of it. Had I got a proper education, I might have been a lawyer or a politician. A villain with a licence. The only thing I liked about school was some of the other boys who were like me. I couldn't wait to grow up and be a member of Billy Hill's gang. Jack wasn't going to go along with that. He'd sooner work as a pearl diver or a casual dock labourer while he was waiting his chance boxing. Work at the docks wasn't regular, but he had to get up early every day and bump on at the gate just the same.
That's it. No more water today.
This is a poxy game, Jack. Getting up at 5 o'clock and bumping on for 3 and 6 a day.
It's worth it when you get a good ship to unload. Plenty of bunts. Hey, look, I'm going running. You want to be my second?
Oh, I'd sooner have a cup of tea and a woodbine. How about that bit of thieving tonight?
What if we get caught? That's my boxing career. Then the army claims us when we get out of jug.
The army's never going to catch us.
You think they've forgotten us?
They won't bother. Look, it's dead easy up at King's Cross railway siding. There's loads of gear in them railway trucks.
What about the night watchman?
Oh, he's an old geezer with a gammy leg. He's too slow to catch a cold.
This is a washout. The trucks are empty.
Oh, try one more. Just one.
No. Let's go before the night watchman comes.
No, wait, wait. Try this one. Good show. Sides are baiting. We'll cop a fortune with rationing still on.
Grab one and get going.
Not on your Nelly. We could get a van and have a load up.
It's real thieving, Bobby. I'm just getting one for mum.
Get another one. One each.
That's it. Come on.
You're no good at this lark, Jack. You best do like Billy will suggest or get a regular job on.
Over you go, Bobby. Take this.
All right. You thieving bugger. Caught you red-handed this time.
Oh, Mr. Watling, I ain't doing nothing.
That side of bacon don't look like nothing.
Well, I bet I can run faster than you.
I'm sure you can. Then it's not just the army after you, but the police. You too, Jack Braden. I can see you behind that fence.
No harm, Mr. Watling. It's just a bit of buxy.
With rationing still on. Oh, I've not had a nice rasher for weeks.
Well, why don't you cop this?
You trying to bribe a policeman?
Well, he wouldn't do that.
We're just trying to get by, Mr. Watling. Fair shares for everyone, let Mr. Attlee say.
Now you're talking. Slap that side of bacon over my crossbar here. Good stuff. Uh-huh. What's that you got, Jack? Another one?
We've got to have something for ourselves.
Thing is, lads, my sergeant likes bacon. He's a greedy bugger. He won't settle for a few rashers.
No, we can't. We only got two.
Plenty more where that came from, I bet.
I'll take my chances on my toes.
Don't be daft. We can go again.
Smart lad is Bobby Brown. You'd do well to listen to him, Jack.
Come on, get on with it. What about it, Governor? You're going to nick us as we come over that fence with more swag?
No. I'll keep cavey. Nip back and get your share. Huh? Off you go.
Get down. It's the night watchman.
Skedaddle.
I'm not going nowhere without a side or two. Like I said, he's old. We could have 6 sides over the fence before he gets here.
We already had one close shave with that copper. How do you know we'd take the offer?
Well, Billy Hill says all coppers are bent.
You can't rely on what he tells you.
Oh, everyone knows what a copper's warrant card is. A license to steal. Come on. You want to try taking 2 each?
Yeah, why not? And again.
Hey, you two.
It's the night watchman. Run!
Let's stop the bacon.
Arsha, Coco.
You've got to give up them fags, Bobby. Yeah. Let me take that. You carry both sides.
Get a move on, slow coaches.
He's coming. Throw them sides over.
Here we go.
Good stuff, good stuff.
Wait, wait. Is that the night watchman? It's the police here. We've got the thieving buggers. The Black Mariah's waiting. You take it easy, old fella.
Skedaddle with your sides. Go on, hop it.
That was a real lesson in criminality for Jack. Until then, he hadn't done any proper thieving. It was his first stark insight into the way the police operated too. Nan wasn't one to keep a good thing to herself. She shared the bacon with half the street. Bobby sold his and blew the money on wine, women and song. After that brush with authority, Jack was more determined than ever to be a boxer and set about getting on with his career. He had good days and bad days. The bad were usually when the MPs knocked the door looking for him and he had to flee out the back bedroom window. And the days when Uncle Billy took the rise out of him for refusing his help were even worse.
Would you Adam and Eve it, Frank? They're slamming each other like a couple of Nancy boys.
Maybe he's having an off day, Billy.
My trainer gets on to me rotten. Do this, don't do that, think another way.
That's what trainers get paid for. Only I don't suppose you pay him.
Anyone can have an off day.
Frank here could make a book on you having an off day.
We could all cop a nice bit of gelt. First, we raise your form.
Go bent, you mean?
No. We get a promoter to set you up with some muds to knock the stuffing out of. That way you make a bit of money for yourself and the right sort of people.
I won't ever get a chance to the title if I'm throwing fights.
What do you think? Boxing's a sport of gentlemen. It's about making money for the right people. Do it right, your career goes forward. If not...
Well, that's all I'd expect from a low-down, rotten crook like Billy Hill.
You think Freddie Mills got to be British champion just by winning his fights? He helped some smart people win a few bob.
It's not how it works. It ain't.
You've got a lot to learn, son. Not just from your trainer. Come on, Frank. This muggle be has been before he's even been a bean.
You take a funny one! I'll never go bent!
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do, 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 shaboom.
Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open, we'll meet again, boom. Ding dong, ding dong, lang, lang, lang. Oh, 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 bip.
You're the most popular lad on our street getting this bacon, Jack. One of these every week would do.
I want to box my way into the headlines, Mum, not for killing a night watchman. I was prepared to hit the old fella rather than get caught. It scared me.
Well, you're a good little provider, my darling. You know what you want, and that's the way. Not like our cat's Joey.
Joey knows what he wants, to have his own business.
He's not going to get far working for that old skinflint at the veg warehouse. He objects to Joey even taking home a few spuds.
The boss always sees me right when I do a bit of portering.
Everyone wants a bit of someone else's success, darling. You're going to make something of yourself.
So's Joey. Goes to night school.
Well, what'd you learn there? How to make baskets? That's not going to feed his family.
What about this boxing like, Mum? It's going bent the only way.
Billy says it's how the world is, Jack.
Billy says. It's all I hear.
If it's the way it is, I can't change it for you, as much as I'd like to.
To hear him talk, it's all fixed. No one gets there on his merit.
He knows what he's talking about. Billy says, I know, but it takes a lot to get a man like him out of your system, whatever his faults.
He's got plenty of them.
Him taking an interest in you means a lot to me. Get what you want, Jack. I don't care if you have to be crooked. Every other bugger is.
You're the real champ, Mum. What would I do without you? Night.
You don't mind Brian bunking in with you? His mum and dad are going to be late.
Oh, the little sod next to covers.
Oh, come back.
I know what Brian will say about this bent fight game. He's got his head screwed on, right?
Night, my darling. Sleep tight.
Right. He's still awake. Oh.
Waiting for you to come up.
I'll move over. I'm on the iron. Oh.
How'd you get such powerful muscles, Jack?
Eating my porridge up.
They feel like concrete. I bet you could beat anyone in the world.
You better get some kip or you won't get up for school.
Oh. Can't I go to the gym and watch you knock the living daylights out of your sparring partners?
I wouldn't have anyone left to spar with if I did that.
You're going to get shot at the title.
It's not easy, Bri. Too many money grabbers wanting you to go bent.
You ain't got to throw the fight, have you?
He told you that?
I heard my mum and Uncle Billy talking.
I told you, he ain't your uncle. Wouldn't happen if your granddad was still here. Him dying like that.
I know. I seen it.
What do you mean you seen it? A doodlebug killed him.
I mean, where it happened. Sullivan's coal yard. I can't go there. Not even to get coal from my mum and...
Don't bother me.
What's that, Jack?
What's wrong with you? You got more rabbit tonight than Archie Andrews on the wireless.
I couldn't bear to see you lose a fight. You ain't going to, are you? You can beat Freddie Mills any day.
First, I need a chance.
Well, maybe you just got to do what Uncle Billy wants.
There you go again. He ain't your uncle.
I forgot. Is he living here now?
This house isn't big enough for both of us.
You could easily throw him out, Jack.
I might move over the road, lodge there.
You could come and live with us. You could share my room. Jack, is Winbooker your girlfriend? Is she? She tells everyone she is. That you're getting married.
She's crackers. How would I ever get a go at a title fight if she's hanging around?
I keep saying she ain't your girl. You ain't interested. You got another girl, Jack.
My trainer says I have to save my strength for the ring.
Jack, strike my arm. Mum does.
Just get some kip.
I'm gonna dream of you winning that title, Jack. You will. I know you will.
I did used to dream regular of Jack winning. I liked it when we had to share a bed. I loved Jack. Not just as an uncle, but I was scared to tell him in case he didn't really understand. He pretended to be a hard man, but I think he felt the same way as me inside. He was fretting about having to throw fights to please the right sorts of people. Jack didn't want that sort of fight, but he had to learn the wicked ways of the world if he was to get on. The trouble was, he went on to learn their wickedness only too well, but more of that later. Jack got his fight, but he hated himself for doing Billy Hill's bidding. He hated Billy more, and as a result, there was trouble headed his way. Big trouble.
Get yourself a mo. I need an urgent word with the champion.
You hear the crowd, Billy? They see I'm killing him. How can I take a dive now?
You better, sunshine. The punters are just old mugs.
They're with me every punch. After them on their feet.
We all know what a great boxer you are, Jack, so it wouldn't have hurt to have lost a couple of rounds before you hit the canvas.
But I can beat this mug easy.
Don't be too sure. He once put Freddie Mills away in two rounds. I did a lot of work getting the smart money the odds I got on you. Influential people in the boxing world will lose a lot of money if you don't do it right.
They'll think I'm muggins.
Just do like I say. It's how the world works. We'll make as much again when we bring you back to win against a contender. So just be sensible, Tiger.
The boxing commentator said Jack Braden was clearly a fighter to watch for. He came out of his corner in the sixth like a tiger. A left to the body, another left, then a left hook split his opponent's right eye wide open, blood everywhere. The mug didn't see any of the blows coming after that. Jack could have finished him in 30 seconds. Instead, Jack hit the deck just before the end of the round and didn't get up. Hearing the disappointment of the crowd at this knockout was the worst experience of Jack's life.
You done lovely, son.
What a show!
Have a cigar. Plenty more where they came from. You certainly know how to throw a left, Jack. I say you're ready to go 2-3 rounds with me.
I'm ready for Freddie Mills. If only them bigwigs would play fair with me, Bobby. I could beat him easily.
With a Savaloy. Everyone out there was sick when you slipped like that. Not Billy, of course. He's on his way in here with Frank Cocaine. I wanted to mark your card, Jack. He's got some young rank starlet called Diana Dawes draped round his neck. God, oh, the tits on her. You'd go two rounds with her, son.
Here he is, the man of the moment. What a fighter. Tell him, Frank.
We all made a packet.
The crowd loved the show you put on for them.
They didn't pay good money to see me on the canvas. I was a mug.
They got their money's worth. Winning wasn't in the plan.
Not your plan.
If you want to take on all comers at Battersea Fairground, the choice is yours. Or you get another match where the right people make money again. Then, if you behave, you meet the number two ranked contender for a knockout.
And what does he do? Trip over his laces in the second. It's what career we're talking about.
What career? You don't have a career, you mug. Not till someone smarter than Blondie here gives it you.
What's she? A scarf around your neck? You cheat on Mum again, it's the last thing you do.
You big sob sister. Take a funny run before I hurt
you. You and the Bash Street kids. Let them take the dive for you.
I tell you what, Jack, it beats portering in Covent Garden. Right, Bobby?
I'd say, Governor, that is collar.
So be sensible. Don't frighten the filly here.
Kill him!
You would want his army!
Let me go! Let me go!
You see what I have to put up with, Diana? Let's pop off to Quo Vadis while the tiger here calms down.
Let me
down.
Go!
You sharp at mums again. I'll top you. I'll kill you!
Go and box some kippers, son. It's all you're good for, you mug.
Jack remained defiant about how he'd box. He wouldn't accept that he had to be bent. Nan urged him to make it up with Billy, saying how he was a forgiving man and still wanted to help. Jack couldn't understand her loyalty to Billy, and for a while moved out and lodged with a neighbour across the road. Billy stayed on at Nan's house and got treated royally by both Nan and my mum. The bad blood between Jack and Billy just got worse. I didn't know at the time what was going on between Mum and Billy Hill. If I'd known what was going to happen, I wouldn't have cared less. But there I am again, getting ahead of myself.
Honey, don't get everything is true. But what it don't get, I can't use. I need money. That's what I want.
In G F Newman's The Corrupted, Joey Oldman was played by Toby Jones, Kath Oldman by Denise Goff, Jack Braden, Tom Weston Jones, Gracie Braden, Ruth Gemmel, Billy Hill, Robert Glenister, Bobby Brown, Charles Davis, PC Watling, Nigel Cook, Wynne Booker, Lottie Rice, Frank Cocaine and Tiger Braden, Michael Eaves, Young Brian by Rory McMenamin, and Spotty, Jonathan Taffler, with Ross Kemp as narrator. G.F. Newman's The Corrupted is a Pacificus production produced and directed by Clive Brill for BBC Radio 4.